Wait, what?
It's all you need, bro.
I'm so confused. Throw some wood through this. I need to see how this works. It turns into... What the f***? You out. This is the wrong way. God damn. Oh, I get it. So it's never going to be more than 10 units long.
And it's lag proof.
Dude, what?
Dude.
The figgity poop.
What? Pretty good. Pretty good.
Guys, Sean here, aka I'm a flying midget. I'm with my boy Zenak. What's good, dude?
What's good, bro?
Zenak is literally he's the man today, okay? He's the man today. So, like I've been kind of teasing, we're gonna be upgrading kind of my saw system today and making it like useful again and making it really, really cool and all that good stuff. Zenak has this amazeballs system. Should we go check it out? Let's go check it out.
I'm really excited actually for releasing this. The video should come out in like a couple days. Recording this and so it will be out when you're seeing this. You can go look at it if you want. It should be out by now.
I'm so hyped.
So right over here, my
man. System, guys, honestly, when I was like, yo, Zenak, I need some help. I heard you got this awesome system. Help me build it. He's like, all right, dude. I'm like, so what do we need to set aside? Like 3 hours to build this thing? He's like, dude, it'll take us like. I think it's like 5-10 minutes. So Zenak, run us through. Explain it.
All right. So I processed all. Well, yeah, I have a log here. Perfect, man. The dude, okay. Right here. So, this thing. This is the entire system.
It literally blew my mind when I saw it. I was like, what? And then I thought about what it did, and I was like, oh my gosh. Okay, go. I'm getting too excited. Explain it.
Yeah. So it's I started building like. These really complicated, huge system. And then I figured, you know, what the heck am I doing? You know, there got to be a simpler way. And so, you know, I started thinking about it, and I thought, you know, why can't we put a saw into my, you know, the sawmill itself? And
can we cut the sawmill?
Yeah. And so we figured out that we could put this little this hatch here into the sawmill itself, and we could also kind of manage to put the saw into the sawmax with a little bit of glitching and stuff like that. So it is, you know, not super, super straightforward, but it's definitely doable. You need two people to do this.
Yeah. So that's the thing is I've never seen it built yet, but I heard it's like kind of complex and you can't really do it yourself. So that's why I got my best friend Zenak here.
Yeah. And yeah, right, I think should we put the yeah. Luckily, we had a piece of wood here. All right. So the wood just kind of goes in, and at the end here, there's a little bit of a hatch that stops it. And this saw is like almost put at the exact place where it can chop it. Like there's a bunch of places when you put the saw in there, which just it doesn't want to chop. So we had to figure out like a really familiar position to put the saw, and for it to cover the entire kind of opening. And yeah, it chops it into perfect pieces just long enough to process.
Exactly. And so if you guys didn't realize that, any log that's over 10 units long, it doesn't matter. You don't need any measuring technique. You literally throw it through, and it basically chops it up and then spits it out on the other side. It's literally amazing, Zenak.
Yeah, it's kind of weird with this this hatch right here. Like, it goes from one side to the other somehow. It's really weird, but it works really, really well. And
I love it. Okay, let's go build
I'm psyched, bro. Should we build let's this? All right.
Oh, of course, let's go. That's cool, man. I'm Usain Bolt. Okay, maybe it'll be me. so I want to kind of leave my system a little bit like how it was because I want to kind of have a cool sorting system. So what we're gonna do is it's better. Zenak said it's better to have your wood be processed before a turn. So we don't necessarily want to have it over here. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna make it straight going off this way. So yeah, let's do that.
Turns are a bit iffy, so like keeping this conveyor as straight as possible is the best. I don't know what Midge is gonna do here, but we're gonna put the thing right here.
Yeah, let's put the thing right there. So what do we need first, Zenak? Like what's step one?
Yeah. So step to one, begin with like we need somewhere to like you know how you need to put down the mill, right? You know how hard it is to align the mill. So I think kind of a good starting point for this is just getting like a groundwork so that we can put it like the mill down easily. And Yeah.
So what if we just did like, what if we did like some large tiles or something?
This is always such a pain, man. Building stuff in the air.
I know, dude. Building stuff in the air is literally the bane to my existence. So it needs to go this way. Okay. This is gonna be really, really, really. Oh.
Did I just? Yeah, that's a little bit off.
You know, it's a little bit off.
Just a little bit.
Hold on, let me see if I can.
Come on, we can get this.
Okay. So we need to move the that one floor, the bottom floor. So let's.
I'm trying. That.
Got it. I got it.
You got it. Okay.
Let's see if we can get this sawmill in place now. Here we go.
It might be a little high. We'll see.
Ooh. Here, let's just see the height wise. Is that?
Ooh.
It's a little low. No, is that?
No, that's on point, dude. That's on point.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. I'm gonna.
Oh.
Yeah. What? I'll build out this platform a little bit just so we get a little bit more space going. And yeah. First important key to this system is like, what?
We're in.
You're kind of lagging out.
Oh, we're money.
Money, you got it. Nice.
Okay.
Nice.
So next step, lay it on us.
Yeah, so the first important step is to find exactly where you want your sawmill. And you just got that right now, so we're pretty golden. Because essentially what you want to do, right, is you want to move it away and then back into the same spots. You wouldn't want to, you know, easily be able to do that. And you also, you know, exactly where, you know, it should be, right? And yeah, we got that pretty solid down right now. So the next thing that we should do is just, we need like all of the different other components ready. So like the saw, like choppers.
Here. I got a hatch right here.
Yeah, wait, what do we need?
We need a hatch, we need a saw.
And we need a lever, wire, saw. We'll just put all this stuff over there. I'm bringing
stack it on top of the sawmill right now. And then you say we need a wire?
Yeah, that's kind of to make it not glitch out the wood on top of the sawmill.
Oh, okay. I'll grab a wire. Wait, what are you grabbing right now? Are you grabbing a saw?
Yeah, I got a saw. Okay. All right.
Wire.
I'm going to try to fill in this these templates too. So we have a little bit of walk-in. What wood should I take for that? This seems very expensive. All of this wood.
Just use birch.
The birch?
I know. Even though birch is my pride and
All right. Birch is also good.
Okay. We might need like a lever to power it, but I have one right here.
I'll come over. Let me see.
All right, we have a saw.
You got a pressure plate, lever, that should be all good to go. The last thing you need is just a bunch of blueprints, which luckily is very easy to kind of put down. Because, like, we have to, you know, be able to put all the different components in the exact,
Do we need to fill in those blueprints? That is a lot of wood.
That is a lot of wood. Yeah, it is a lot of wood.
I thought that would fill it up easily.
Do
we need to fill them in or no?
I don't know. I think we should just kind of fill it in to get like a comfortable platform to walk on, because it's a bit cheeky to put all these components down.
Here, I'll hold this, and you grab another one.
All right. We can do like a little break, just setting this up if you want.
Okay, yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and do that.
Yeah, little break, and we'll be back once we got the platform.
2,000 years later.
Alrighty, Zenak. Now we got our birch platform.
Dude, this took so long.
This took so much wood.
So. The next thing you want to kind of do is we need to lay out like a couple of blueprints, and I'll do this. We need a little bit of like a staircase shape over here. I did a tutorial on this, bro. I got these placements down.
All right. Okay, so
We need one on each side like that. Okay. And that should be everything you need for the saw setup. And now we want to remove these, like the bottom ones again, so that it's easy to place down like the actual saws. And I can't destroy this, like I can move them, I guess.
So you want me to, you just move them.
Yeah.
So I'm not entirely sure which ones you want to move.
Whoa. Almost moved the saw.
So you just want basically the top one and the two like tiles basically.
Yeah, so we only need like the two little edges. Like it's really important that we have this like little tile on the end here. Replacing this out. We can also move this. It's whatever. All right, so that's pretty much it. And now comes like the hardest part of the system. There might be a little too, like we might have to kind of remove some more of this on this side.
Okay.
Because essentially, problem. All right, there's two jobs here, bro. There's two jobs.
Okay. So we have two jobs.
We have two jobs, okay. two little bit different jobs. So one dude has to kind of do the sawmill job, which what he will have to do is he will have to move it away and then move it back and not put it down, pretty much.
Okay.
And while you have it there, right? You haven't put it down. It's just in that, you know, exact place, which it is now, like the sawmax.
Right, right.
At the same time, I want to put down the chop saws on each side.
Okay.
And,
so it's a little
then
bit
you,
like a yeah. glitch.
Yeah, it is kind of glitching.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, that's what we're going to have to try and do.
This
so I think
Lumber
Tycoon
is the definition of glitchy, so.
Yeah, dude, it's so easy, bro. So easy.
Okay, so what you want to do the saw, I'll do the hatch or something?
Yeah, dude, I think we'll need a little bit of space, by the way.
More space?
Yeah, because, I mean, the saw has to kind of stick out. Wait, I'll show you. So we'll have to, we actually want to kind of get two saws, but it's whatever. Okay, so yeah, we want to try and put this down. Like, you see how I can't put it down on the thing.
Oh, so you need a little more, okay, I got you.
Yeah, that's why we need, that's why we need the glitchiness going for it. Yeah, so
my base is repulsive right now. It's so messy. I need to clean it.
Yeah, I think you should be good. I don't think you have to remove this. I think you should be able to do it.
Okay.
So yeah. Which kind of job do you want to try and take on? Should I do the more difficult saw job, maybe?
Yeah, I was going to say, maybe I'll do the saw max and you do the saw job.
Yeah, all right. You guys won't be seeing both perspectives of this. So if you guys want to learn how to do this, again, there will be a tutorial, so you can check that out. It'll be a little bit more simple.
Okay, so how do I... So I just... what do I do? Tell me what I do so I don't mess this up.
So what you want to do now is you want to move the sawmax away. Just move it to another location. Just move it away so that it's not here anymore.
Okay, hold on.
First of all.
Okay.
All right. And now what you want to do is you want to move it back, but you do not want to place it, all right?
Place it. Okay. Hold on.
Like, I got to make sure now that while you have it in that spot, I don't want to walk in front of your cursor or anything. And I have to try and put down...
Okay, I can't tell if it's on. This is the thing that's going to be frustrating for me.
Yeah, so you have to get it kind of in the same place. So aligned up with the conveyor in front is kind of how you measure that.
I think it's lined up, so I'm not going to move
it. All right. All right, I'm going to grab the second saw over here. So we get both saws, you know? We need that efficiency, you know?
We need that efficiency, both saws. Man?
Yeah.
Come on. Don't run, I guess, just where the sawmill is. Like, my cursor, I'm facing towards you right now.
So I want to make sure not to walk like in your way, because that will mess up the placement.
Wait.
So yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna put down one saw. You can see now that your blueprint should be in the same place, right?
Right. Yeah. It hasn't moved.
That's exactly what we want. All right. And then I'm gonna grab the.
Okay. Gosh, this is so underground MLG stuff right now. I'm excited.
Dude, this is underground, bruh. All right. I'm gonna get the. Oh, and having to rotate that. Okay, I got it, dude. I'm a master rotator.
Okay,
all right.
Okay, man.
Let's go.
I wasn't calling you out.
No, but dude, I had so much trouble.
Now do
with
I
that
place?
Usually. Yeah, so now you want to place it?
So this is the moment of truth where I find out if it was actually lined up or not.
Bam! Nice!
Yes! Okay, nice.
So as you can see now, like if we activate these, like those are now inside of the sawmill. And that should now
so the efficiency goes up.
Yeah. So yeah, that is kind of the setup right there, dude. There's one last thing that we need. Yes. We need
a little hatch right here.
Yeah.
So I don't.
All right.
Is there like a special placement for that?
Yeah,
how does that work?
It's not too difficult. What you want to just do is you want to get a another small tile. I like to use these tileless blueprints, like the square, like 1x2 or 2x whatever. Yeah, and you want to put that right. No, hold up. That's not the right place. You want to put it right there, and that should be
so
it.
Hanging over. Oh no. Yeah, just hanging over it.
You have the. Do you want to try and put this down?
No, not really.
Alright,
I don't want to mess it up.
Okay, all so right. You want to put it upside down.
Just place it right next to it, though, and then upside down to where it goes underneath. It shouldn't be too hard, yeah.
Yeah, this is what it got to look like. So now we'll go...
And you activate it with... Bam,
inside
boys!
The thing. And
bam,
that,
boys!
That is... You see all these complicated saw systems out there, guys? It's this simple, alright?
Move this wire literally just right here to make it not glitch. So like this to that, right? Like we literally just do that.
Yeah, you got the skills, bro. You got the skills, dude.
I got this stuff down. All right, so this is like the simplest yet so like I think this is one of the most effective systems I've ever seen. So Zenak, yeah. You are the man.
The man.
Shall we test?
I think we should test.
Yay! Get some wood. Let's get some wood. Yo, hop in my truck, man.
Yeah, there's one thing. We have to hook up a lever to this, but we can just do that when you get back.
Oh yeah, to make simple. Hop in, boy.
I'll get in. So you kind of just want to put your lever wherever you want it. That's like super up to you kind of thing.
I think I'll put it somewhere where we can easily activate it, because you don't want the sawmill noise can be so annoying if it's always on. I'm gonna want to turn that thing off every once in a while. Okay, let's not just.
So you can put it in your base and you can turn it off exactly when you don't want it on and stuff.
Right.
And it's all Gucci. All right.
It's all good. Yo, help me chop this thing, man. What, are you just watching me? Watching me do manual labor?
Dude, I'll I was going to say, I'll help you once there's more to chop, but we can totally cooperate.
So I can't even have
you. Wrecked. All right, hold on.
You just stole my tree.
Stole your tree, bruh. All right, okay, there you go. Right. Whoa. Lag spike. All right. Whoa. I'm going to get the branch up here.
I think our truck will explode in a second.
Okay.
So that's good.
All right.
That was one. You can't have an episode with us without something.
Dude, you reset my chopping progress somehow.
Oh, man. I'm sorry, man. Okay, there we go.
Correct. All right. Okay, that's fine. Just remember there's probably a little bit of a modification that you want to do, but I think you can do that on your own. I'll kind of explain when we get over there, just to make it even a little bit more fast and efficient.
Let's just take two, then. We'll just snag these two. Go for it.
I'll get this one. Are you good? You have enough?
Yeah, I have one in here. Just grab that one we just cut, and then we should be good with two.
Yeah.
So the thing that's great about this saw system is you don't have to worry about what type of wood you're getting. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, so the thing that kind of messed me up was when I'm... Yeah. What?
You remember in our collab, bro?
Yeah, dude.
You're like it's not possible. I'm like, it's possible, bro.
Dude, when I was like designing a system, I was like, you know, it's great for this wood or it's great for this wood, but it's not great for all the woods because each one has different thickness, because you can't really have like a measuring system because then the thickness is off and yada, yada, yada. Oh, do you want to make that efficiency change real quick?
Bro, we need to add the levers.
You're right. Then I was like, there's a lever over here, by the way. This system literally works regardless of how intense or how like big or small the wood is. It's literally just amazing. I'm just going to set it right here for right now just to... I'm gonna have to redo a lot of this system to make it look good and make it more efficient, but
is actually like what you want to do. I kind of want to note this out right now. You probably what you want to do is put another sawmill before this, that everything just goes through, because then all of the small pieces won't be stuck behind the long pieces waiting to get chopped up. You got me?
I got you.
That is like a really good modification that you could do to this to make
that's
it even better.
Wait, but then wouldn't it get stopped in the, oh no, because it would glitch on the other side.
The processed
hatch,
wood
right?
will drop down and the wood that doesn't will continue. Yeah.
So don't look at
we
that.
We could probably work on that, you know, in another little video maybe. Well,
but so basically what I'm saying is it, like the small woods that don't need to be processed, they'll just glitch on the other side of the hatch, correct?
Yeah, the bad thing though is that, you know, if there's a long wood piece in front, then all of the small ones will be stuck in the behind, even though they would, you know, if they went through, they would actually get instantly processed. But because there's a long piece, they won't, because they have to wait.
Okay. Oh, I know why it's not working, because I have to, like, finish the wire here and add another wire. I don't know why.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, I could have sworn I lined that one up perfectly.
Yeah.
Right. Boom, and see, the sawmill noise is already killing me. There we go.
Nice.
Okay. Let's check this bad. Also, can you delete these blueprints right here?
Yeah, you can totally delete those now. It's fine.
And these sawmills can definitely kill you right here too. So
yeah, double efficiency.
Double efficiency. Wait, you just walked right through it.
Yeah.
Oh, they don't hurt you. I thought they did.
I think they. It's just like kind of weird because we're like just touching the top part or something right now.
Yeah.
But yeah, okay. Let's get the wood.
Let's throw these bad boys through. I'm hyped.
Test it out. So let's try with one first.
Okay, let's see what we got.
Yes, I've not actually tested it with both saws before. So it'll be cool to see, you know, how efficient. Yeah, I've just done one.
It's just not even going to work. Watch. No, just kidding.
No, it is going to work. It's like just mirrored,
it's
you know?
Just kidding. Yeah.
Alright, well, let's try
it. I'm excited. This is gonna make gathering wood so much easier.
Yeah. Alright, let's see this. Dude, let's see this will help you out.
What do we got? What do we got? What do we got?
So as you can see the chop marks?
Yeah. So I'm like, and... I always watch. Oh, there it is. There it is.
Boom!
Boom!
There we go, son!
Damn, boys! And so, could you change it? Obviously, if you're processing a lot of wood, you're going to want it to be the max size as the planks. But if you only had one piece of wood, can you make it into, like, a really long, like, one by one? Is that a thing?
Or no? So, dude, you want to change the size of it just to YOLO? See how long we can get up? Oh, you did. All right.
So let's see what happens. Oh, so they're both coming out. See? So this is why if I had another wood that went in right now, it'd get way too nuts.
Yeah.
Man, it looks like spaghetti.
Looks like spaghetti. Oh.
Looks like
yeah, I mean, that is the really thing. Maybe not for long planking. But yeah, I mean, when the heck do you want these things anyway?
Yeah, honestly, like the only time I ever make these one by ones is when I'm building like small tiles and I have a separate sawmill for that.
Yeah. Like, you just imagine like carrying like 10 of these to the selling.
Wait,
did
they
selling.
Just glitch out?
Oh.
Oh, rip the dream. It's probably because they were falling. Because I have nothing afterwards, but that's right.
Yeah, and it was two inside of each other. Yeah, no, I think if you want long pieces with you to the selling store, man, that's all on you.
Yeah, I was going to say, probably not the best method, but...
Yeah.
Dude, GG on the system, Zenak. This thing is insane. GG. I love the simplicity and how, like, effective it really is.
Mm-hmm.
It's honestly, dude, 10 out of 10 GGs. Zenak's the man, the myth, the legend.
Yes.
All right, dudes. Well, I think that is going to do it for today. We hope you guys enjoyed the video. Again, go subscribe to Zenak, okay? He's dropping a tutorial for the system. This is arguably one of the best systems in Lumber Tycoon that I've ever seen. So definitely go subscribe to him. Go check out his video when he puts up that way up, dude. But yeah, that is it. Zenak, you're the man. You're the man.
Yeah.
All right, dudes. Well, we appreciate you guys watching. Smash that like button if you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think of this system. And until next time, guys, if you haven't already, make sure you be fly and subscribe.
Goodbye.
GG.
GG, dude. I never know how to do these outros.
I can't even